All right, guys, a little phone action for you this evening. So, camera died, no more batteries. Been out here since early this morning. So, we just tied on a big swim bait. It was the end of the day, had some music playing, and it was like one of those why not type of moments. Let me show you what we got.
Pulled that swim bait out of our new Black Pack Pro. Go pick you up one.
Check it.
Hey.
All right, I hate in the house unboxings. You guys are gonna have to forgive me. I've done like one on the channel when I edit them. I kind of cringe. I feel like if you fish, you should just always be outside, you know? I'm sure this might be the first Larry Melton Jr. video that you might be watching. I'm sure I have some returning subscribers watching this video, but some new people might get to watch this video. I make kayak fishing videos. I pond fish, bank fish. So I still walk. I hunt. Sometimes I sing during my videos. That's the rundown of the channel. Yak Attack sent me the new Black Pack Pro. So I'd say I've been kayak fishing for about a year now. I have an Old Town Salty PDO 120. I love it. But the crate that I currently use is just a milk crate. So like the videos, the milk crate challenge, I use one of those. Good budget option. But this is like 100 times better. I'm just gonna open it and I'll kind of tell you my testimony to kayak fishing as I open this box. I got my kayak. What, last January? So yeah, I've been kayak fishing for a year now. It's probably like my new favorite way to fish, just because if I can't walk all the way around the pond, I really don't even like stopping, because a lot of the ponds where I fish, I live in Birmingham, Alabama, so a lot of the ponds are really heavily pressured. So I feel like if I have to stand where everybody else is standing, not saying I'm better than anybody, but like I just kind of have a mental problem with like fishing the same exact area that was probably fished 5 minutes before. Kayak was my best option. I haven't really bought into any accessories. I think the only thing that I bought is like some boxes to put my batteries and whatnot in, waterproof batteries. But as far as anything to actually go on the kayak, this is going to be the first thing. I'm super excited about it. I'm the guy that like fills on boxes and fills the packaging, you know. I get the rod tubes too. I did not know the rod tubes came with. I guess I could have watched, paid a little bit more attention. All right, so this is the 13x16. They also make a 16x16, which is gonna be a little bit bigger. I'm gonna go ahead and put it together, put it on the back of my kayak, which is sitting in the back of my truck, and tell you what I think about it. One thing that I'm very pumped about is that this one, I'm pretty sure the base of it has rubber pads, so it won't slide around as much and won't make as much noise in the back of the kayak. Okay, so they have a 13x13, 13x16, and 16x16. This one is the 13x16. So in your box, you're gonna get your panels for the Black Pack. You're gonna have to assemble it yourself. Luckily, I am a handyman. We get 4 rod holders. One thing I'm super pumped about having 4, because the rod holders all fell off of my old milk crate. So I just had the generic milk crate. Like I said, they all fell off. So we have 4 rod holders. You get a bag with, sure, this is probably just connection stuff. And then the rod holders actually come with leashes to wrap around your rods while they're in the holder. So that's going to be pretty sweet. I really just have to put it together and kind of read over the instructions, because I've watched Chad Hoover has a video on YouTube about this crate. And I've watched his, but I really haven't paid it any more attention since I watched it the first time. These panels look so sweet. It says Yak Attack on it. That looks... Tell me that doesn't look dope. Alright guys, so connection with this is super simple. It all literally bumps together. All right, we have a lot of screws we had to screw in, so we went and got a drill.
I mean, Yak Attack does it.
First thing I'm gonna say is you're definitely gonna need a drill. You could do it with a screwdriver. There's only 4 screws that hold each side together. And then I think my next step is I have to put 4 on each panel on the bottom. Putting this thing together is super simple. There's nothing that like you haven't done before that you're gonna have to do with this.
a little later.
Alright guys, so I got the Black Pack Pro installed, put together. It took me probably about 30-45 minutes to put it all together. I did use a drill, you saw that in the video. I kind of took a little break from recording and I just put together super simple, nothing that like you really have to go out of your way to do. Everything fits super well. I have a lot of positive stuff to say about this. So to be 100% transparent with you guys, I put this together, I left it on the kayak outside in the rain overnight, opened it the next morning. I was like, I cannot believe I just did that. Completely dry on the inside. I'm not sure if it drained out, but the kayak was still wet. Box, everything on the inside completely dry. That was a huge plus in my eyes. How I have this rigged, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have 6 3700 size boxes, Plano Edge boxes. Then I have 1 3600 size that I put the long way. So I have 2 smaller 3700 size boxes. So these are about half the size of a full size box. So see this one right here, it's pretty thick versus a terminal box or my jerkbait box. See, those are pretty thin. So with the regular size 3700 boxes, I'd say this is like the standard size. I'd say you could probably fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you could fit 6 3700 size boxes in like this. So if I try to turn them the long way, I wouldn't be able to close the crate, but that really wouldn't be that big of a deal for me. I fished my old milk crate with them sticking out of the top like that. One thing that I really do appreciate that I thought I really wouldn't care for, I never had the regular backpack Black Pack. I said it before, or said it earlier in the video, I've only had like a milk crate challenge milk crate. So one thing that I really do appreciate is this top, just for keeping your gear dry. I mean, it goes a long way. If you're not fishing with the Edge boxes, or if you don't, I mean, if you just have your stuff loose laying around in here, keeping it dry if it's raining outside, that's gonna help not rust out your hooks and keep your lures happy for a long period of time. So I fished this crate on the new John/pontoon boat all day today, handled great. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this crate out and I'm gonna kind of like show y'all how I use it on my, yeah. So I have enough room to keep my GoPro batteries and everything inside of here too. So this is a little waterproof Plano case. And if this Black Pack is waterproof, I'm just double protected right here. We have these connectors right here. This is, you can connect this to the bungees in the back of a kayak using these right here. You have these solid handles on the side. I put all 4 of my rod holders on the back. Normally when I go out, I try to take the least amount of rods I possibly can take because, you know, I don't want to have an accident. But these little tether tubes, you have a nice sturdy handle right here, made in the USA. It just has a great design. It's all black, orange logo, made in the USA on the top. 13 by 16 is the perfect size. I feel like the 16 by 16 would be a little bit too big for me. This is like just a smidge bigger than my milk crate. It's a smidge wider and a smidge taller. So I think this is just perfect. I would go 13 by 16 all day. If you have maybe like a smaller 10-foot kayak, this is still gonna fit in the back of it. If you want to downsize to that 13 by 13, I mean, do you, but I feel like this is just plenty enough for everything that I want to take. This is anything that I could possibly need. Cranks, terminal, topwater, big swim bait, jerk bait, and all my jigs and whatnot. And then I have a smaller terminal box that I used to just use for my kayak in the crate too. So then I still have enough room. If I wanted to, I could fit 2 more of these small boxes, or I could fit maybe 2 more of the thin or 1 of the regular size on top of the 7 that I already have in here. So storage on this thing is not an issue. The screws right here, I love how they designed that to be kind of like recessed on the inside of the plastic, because on my milk crate, I drilled some holes in it. You had to watch out for the screws on the inside of the milk crate. So super nice design, super fancy. It's just nice to have. Yeah, so we're gonna get out on this pond. We're gonna probably fish topwater out this evening. Why not? Looks like a nice topwater evening. So all right, so here's the pack on the water. We're gonna try to catch some bass this evening. We filmed another video earlier today and I was just gonna kind of like show y'all the crate and whatnot all put together, but then I was thinking, I was like, why not make it a fishing video? I'd like to make fishing videos. So Yeah, this is a crate. It has lots of room. One thing either I wish came with the crate or I might put on the crate. I wish there was like netting, because I use netting on my other milk crate to put my scale, pliers, stuff like that in, so I didn't have to like take it out of the boat. I could just grab my crate. Everything was in the crate. Didn't have to worry about losing anything or missing out on. That might be like a upgrade I might try to do to the crate, is find like a little mesh bag or something to attach to the side of it.
All right, let's see if we can find a big enough bass.
I don't want to eat it. That was our first bite of the day on a frog. Turned around and looked behind me and turned back around and there was ripples all around my frog. All right, topwater attempt. We did it for 15, 20 minutes. No luck. Well, probably about 30, 40 minutes, no luck. Guys, this is like my favorite pond because it looks like it's like a Florida pond. It's kind of like a little vacation pond for me. I feel like I'm not in Alabama. I feel like I'm in Florida. And then the fish in here are really pretty too, so. See if maybe I can catch one. All right, it's so calm back here. We're gonna switch over to AJ Walker.
Seconds later.
All right, guys, a little phone action for you this evening. So I camera died, no more batteries, been out here since early this morning, so we just tied on a big swim bait. It was end of the day, had some music playing, and it was like one of those why not type of moments. Let me show you what we got. Big swim bait fish, baby. Something about catching, I hit it twice and I was like, oh yeah, I love a good big swim bait fish. This is probably a good solid. It's probably right at 4. Man, let's go.
Chasing a bag, I'm racing the clock. Look at him flop, watching him flop. Used to see this in my sleep. When I ain't had shit but my thoughts in the car, I really was lost. Now I'm public with the soundscapes.